Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question which says, the following table gives the daily income of 50 workers of a factory. In this table, we are given the daily income and the number of workers for each class interval of the daily income. We have to find the mean, mode and median of the above data. Before we move on to the solution, let's recall the formulae to find the mean, mode and median for a given data. First of all, we have mean, that is x bar is equal to a plus summation fi ui upon summation fi, this whole multiplied by h, where we have this a is the assumed mean, h is the class size, where fi is the frequency corresponding to xi, where xi is the class mark. Then we have ui is equal to xi minus a upon h, where again xi is the class mark. Next we have the formula to find out the mode for a given data. Mode is equal to n plus f1 minus f0 upon 2f1 minus f0 minus f2, this whole multiplied by h, where we have L is the lower limit of the modal class, then H is the class size, F1 is the frequency of the modal class, F0 is the frequency of the class preceding the modal class, then F2 is the frequency of the class succeeding the modal class, the next we have the formula to find out the median. This is equal to L plus N upon 2 minus CF, this whole upon F, and this whole multiplied by h, where we have L is the lower limit of the median class, N is the number of observations, CF is the cumulative frequency of the class preceding the median class, then F is the frequency of the median class, and H is the class size. Let's move on to the solution now. So we have this table in which we have the daily income, that is the given class intervals, number of workers, that is the corresponding frequencies for the given class intervals, Fi, Xi, which is the class mark, then Ui given by the formula Xi minus A upon H, FiUi and CF, that is the cumulative frequency. Now xi, that is the class mark, is given by upper limit plus lower limit upon 2. So for the first class interval, it would be 110. Then for the next class interval, it is 130. For the next class interval, it is 150. For the next class interval, it's 170. And for the next class interval, it's 190. Now first of all, we'll find the assumed mean A. We take the assumed mean A to be that xi which lies in the center of all xi's. So from all xi's, you can see that 150 lies in the center of the given xi's. So we have taken A, that is the assumed mean, as 150. The class size H is equal to 20. Let us now find out ui for each class interval. It is given by xi minus assumed mean A upon the class size H. So for the first class interval, it is 110 minus 150 upon 20. So it would be minus 2. For the next class interval, it would be minus 1. For the next class interval, it would be 0. For the interval 160 to 180, ui is equal to 1. For the interval 180 to 200, ui is 2. Now fi into ui, that is fi multiplied by ui. Now 12 multiplied by minus 2 is minus 24. 14 multiplied by minus 1 is minus 14. 8 multiplied by 0 is 0. 6 multiplied by 1 is 6. 10 multiplied by 2 is 20. Now let's find out the cumulative frequencies for each class interval. For the first class interval, that is 100 to 120, cumulative frequency is given by 12. Now for the next class interval, 120 to 140, it is given by 14 plus 12, that is 26. For the next class interval, it is 8 plus 26, which is 34. Now for the next class interval, it is 6 plus 34, that is 40. For the next class interval is 10 plus 40, that is 50. Now the total frequency, that is summation fi, is equal to 12 plus 14 plus 8 plus 6 plus 10. That comes out to be equal to 50. Then summation fi ui is equal to minus 24 minus 14 plus 0 plus 6 plus 20, which comes out to be equal to minus 12. So we have summation fi ui is equal to minus 12. Now let's find out the mean first. Mean is given by x bar is equal to, using this formula, we will substitute the respective values and find out the mean. So we have mean x bar is equal to A, that is 150, plus summation fi ui, which is minus 12, upon summation fi, that is 50, and this whole multiplied by h, which is the class size, and that is 20. Now this 0 cancels with this 0, and we get this is equal to 150 minus 24 upon 5, which is equal to 750 minus 24 upon 5. That is, we get this is equal to 726 upon 5, which comes out to be equal to 145.2. So we have the mean x bar is equal to 145.2. Next we'll find out mode. Now before we find out mode, we should know the modal class. Modal class is the class with the maximum frequency. Now from this table we find that the maximum frequency is 14, and so modal class is 120 to 140. Now mode is equal to, putting the respective values in this formula, we get mode is equal to L, which is the lower limit of the modal class, and in this case it would be 120. So 120 plus F1, which is the frequency of the modal class, and that is 14. So here we have 14 minus F0, which is the frequency of the class preceding the modal class. Now class preceding the modal class is 100 to 120 and its frequency is 12. So here we have 12 upon 2F1, that is 2 into 14 minus F0, which is the frequency of the class preceding the modal class, and that is 12, minus F2, which is the frequency of the class succeeding the modal class. And in this case, the class succeeding the modal class is 140 to 160 and its frequency is 8. So here we have 8, and this whole multiplied by H, which is the class size, and that is 20. So this is equal to 120 plus 2 upon 28 minus 20 whole multiplied by 20. Further equal to 120 plus 2 upon 8 multiplied by 20. Now 2, 4 times is 8, and 4, 5 times is 20. So this is equal to 120 plus 5, which is equal to 125. So we get mod is equal to 125. Next we'll find the median. Now we have n is equal to 50, and n upon 2 would be equal to 50 upon 2, that is 25. First we'll find the median class. Median class is the class whose cumulative frequency is greater than and nearest to n upon 2, and in this case median class would be the class whose cumulative frequency is greater than or nearest to 25. So look at this table. Now the cumulative frequency greater than 25 or nearest to 25 is 26. So the class interval 120 to 140 is the median class. That is, the class interval 120 to 140 is the median class. Now we'll find out the median. We'll substitute the respective values in this formula to find out the median. So median is equal to L, that is the lower limit of the median class, and in this case it would be 120 plus N upon 2, which is 25, minus CF, that is the cumulative frequency of the class preceding the median class. Now class preceding the median class is 100 to 120, its cumulative frequency is 12, so CF would be 12. So here we have 12 upon F, which is the frequency of the median class, and that is 14. So here we have 14, and this whole multiplied by H, that is the class size, which is 20. So further we get this is equal to 120 plus 13 upon 14 into 20. Now 2, 7 times is 14, and 2, 10 times is 20. And this is equal to 120 plus 130 upon 7. So further we get 840 plus 130 upon 7. That is, we have 970 upon 7, which is equal to 138.57. So this is the median. Thus we have got the value for median also. So we have got the values for mean, mode and median for the given data. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.